Welcome to Urban Fishing Show.
Today we're in Miami.
We're a mile and a half from Miami International Airport. We have the airplanes flying over our heads.
Jet skis in the canal.
This is about as urban as you can get.
I'm Nicole.
And I'm Dave.
And today we're fishing for a peacock bass in Miami, Florida.
So the peacock bass actually were introduced by the Florida Fish and Game in 1984 in order to help control the population of non-native fish species that were released into the canal systems.
The peacock bass are found in the canals because they cannot live in low water temperatures. The canals are perfect because they've never reached below 66, and the peacock bass really like the 70s.
Now, one of the biggest things is that recently there was that big cold snap that just came through about 3 months ago. And as you probably heard, a lot of the snook, a lot of the other major species, the sea trout, wide fish kills in that area. The peacock bass were also pretty heavily hit with the cold front that came through, but it looks like their numbers have sustained pretty well. You ready to go catch some fish?
Let's do it.
So today, since these fish only get about 1 to 5 pounds, we're using ultra lightweight. So we're using 8 pound test rods, 8 pound test line, and then very small, only about a 5 foot rods. Now they don't cast quite as well, but when these smaller fish hit, they fight like they're 15, 20 pounds since we have such light tackle. So this is one of the iguana population that was, everybody came and had them as pets down here, and they started releasing back into the wild when they got too big like this guy. Now over the years they've started to actually populate the canal system. So let's see if we can get him to move around a little bit. If we go too close to this guy, he would actually go and jump right into this big canal, probably scaring the fish we want to catch. But as you can see, I mean, we are right in the middle of this area and he's just having a great time. So if we can find this guy, let's hope we can find some fish next to him. This is a soft plastic, it's a jerk bait, and it's primarily right on top of the water. What you do is you, since it's soft plastic, it moves very freely. It looks a lot like a injured fish, like most lures out there, but since it's soft, it wiggles. Technical term. So these fish are just like bass in that if you are, they're gonna be hanging out, they're gonna try and just run under the water. You're gonna wanna make your lure just look like the natural bait fish that's injured. Fish are right along the sides, by the bridges, anywhere like that, and that's where they're gonna be hiding. They're more ambush. So, especially underneath this bridge where Nicole is right now.
So today I'm trying a gold Rapala in my lure. Shiny, about the same size as the fish that we got last week. I was trying to keep it more just kind of bobbing on the top, trying to look like it was an injured fish. So that to do that, you just kind of jig, you know, consistently and then one big pull. So that way it's going, swimming, swimming, oh, trying to get water.
I'm just waiting for some fish to come out of these dark kind of bronzy areas and just engulf this thing. It's like, it's just the biggest thrill from fishing. I mean, each cast you have no idea what's really gonna happen next.
Dave, I saw a fish following mine.
Really?
Yeah, it's awesome. It definitely was like checking it out. I just saw it again. Oh, I felt it. Okay, I know I have the right lure. I know I'm going at the right speed. So cool, I can see them.
So I'm going on the far side. I'm going to try and avoid the security guard that keeps going back and forth. So I'm going to try and hide under here with you.
Yeah.
Now, when you're fishing a bridge like this, what you want to try and do is really just try to get your bait or your lure or whatever else you're using, put it right next to these pilings. A lot of times at the bottom, those rock little rock beds where these fish will just hide. And that's what you're really trying just to get it right in there so they can feel like they're just jumping onto something and attacking it and never saw it coming. It's a fish, I got one. I don't know what it is.
I have the slightest idea what the hell this is. But I caught one.
Now I was just kind of jigging this right in the bottom, trying to get a reaction, and well, this guy came up and grabbed it. Let's see if I can get him up here for you. He's really pretty.
No idea what he is though.
Gobble this thing down.
got some like fight in him. He may not look big, but he is.
This is lightweight tackle is awesome.
Sick. Wow. Look at all those fins.
There we go, first. This is our first fish in Miami. I have no idea what it is, I'll be honest. We're gonna have to look this one up and tell you later on what it is. But it is a great fight, and look how gorgeous he is with these fins. So let's let him go now. One fish in the line.
That's
yeah, that's cool. I want back my rod. This is mine. So we didn't catch anything this episode for the peacock bass wise, but we did get that one really random fish. Have no idea what it is still. We'll try to keep you updated next time we come on air. Once we ask some of the other experts, like we said, we're not experts. We're out here having a great time and showing you they can fish in the middle of any major city, New York, Delaware, now Miami, next Orlando. So until next time, tight line, screaming reels. This is David Harding.
Thanks for watching. Nicole, happy fishing.
Bye, guys.
Estaba dedicado.